This is how excited I am to talk to you about engineering. By the way, did you ever notice that I have a kayak in my room? That's right. There. One of two kayaks, actually. So, welcome everyone back to my channel. Basically, I love engineering and I wanted to tell you why I love engineering and why you should love engineering too, even if you're in the middle of exams right now and you hate everything and you hate everyone. Here are some reasons why engineering is still the best and why you should continue doing it. Okay, reasons why I love being an engineer. Number one, it's fun. Is it fun? Yes, it is. Once you find something within your domain that you like, it's fun. I promise. Just find out what you like within engineering. Number two, you're never the smartest person in the room. There's always someone smarter than you and always something that you can learn from someone else. Number three, literally no problem seems too difficult for me to solve. Even if it's something impossible, like I actually went climbing a mountain and I didn't have the proper shoes at all, and everyone was like, you can't go climbing this glacier in those shoes. And I'm like, watch me. To be fair, I almost died, but my engineering mindset was like, if I can work on a code that, like, on a script that will never ever work, and the day before I have to hand it in, it starts working, then I can climb this mountain in these shoes. And I did, and I didn't die, even though I could have died, but okay, basically, there's no problem that you will not be able to solve, because you will stick it through. Four, security. It's especially scary for me because I live in Switzerland and I can get kicked out of the country at any moment. But with the engineering degree, I feel like pretty secure, like I'll be able to find something in Switzerland. Five is the pay. The internships that I've had in the past have been paid way more than other internships. Actually, some of my friends are in like studying to be doctors and whatever, MDs, and all of like the internships that they've had to like volunteer in hospitals and like volunteer here and volunteer there. And they're always surprised to know that like engineering internships are paid. And I'm like, well, yeah, I'm not gonna do like real engineering work for a firm for free. Are they kidding me? Like, no. Like, who's gonna do engineering work for free? No one. Six is I have an extremely logical like approach to life decisions. I'm just very logical in all of my decision making, and so far it's worked out for me, and I really like that about myself. But that came about from like studying engineering. So as I studied more engineering, like this sort of developed within me. So I appreciate engineering for giving that to me. Okay, seven, I don't let emotions influence my decisions. Just throughout all of the stress of doing engineering projects, I have like suppressed my emotions. Does that make sense? Like, I'm able to put my emotions in a box and focus on the task at hand. And I think that's a really useful skill to have. Okay, eight, I'm very critical of information that I receive. Most of the time, if I see something on Facebook or wherever else, like, I won't take the information given to me, like, at face value. Like, a lot of the time, I wanna see, like, data behind it. I think it's important to be able to pull from different sources and develop your own opinion on subjects instead of just, like, listening to what other people are saying. Okay, number nine is I've become super efficient at everything I do. For me, throughout my undergrad, like what I got really good at is like I work, and then like Friday night, I'm able to go get a beer and like watch the hockey game or something like that. Okay, number 10 is just like, it just goes with number nine. Like I efficiently plan my time, getting things done efficiently, but also planning things so that they can be done efficiently when I get around to doing them. Number 11 is I'm able to find the root of any problem. And I know I say any problem, but like even when my friends are having like problems with, I don't know, family or personal issues, I feel like a psychologist sometimes. Like I'm able to like figure out like why are they feeling this way? Why are they acting this way? I don't know, like it's weird, but like I think that's due to engineering. Maybe I just think everything is due to engineering. But I wasn't like this before I went into undergrad, and now I'm pretty much an emotional guru. Maybe that's because I don't have emotions and I'm trying to figure out why other people have emotions. Okay, 12. There's a lot less jealousy in engineering. It's like, I know my friends were in business. They would be like, oh, I can't miss a class. And I'm like, why not just ask a friend for like notes? And they're like, no, no one will give me notes. Like people don't share notes in business because blah, 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 blah. They want to get ahead, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, that's stupid. Like, just tell them, no, give me your notes. And like, if I went into an engineering class and I was like, hey, can you give me the notes? I wasn't here for the last 3 months. Like, people would hand them over. And if they didn't, I'd be like, give me your notes. Who do you think you are? I haven't seen any jealousy in engineering because we're all suffering together. Number 13, I don't overthink things too much. I think that's like a great skill to have. Engineering has allowed me to not overthink things and generally just not care about anything. 14, I feel like I always have emergency topics to talk about. For example, I once went on a date with this guy and I literally ran out of things to say, so I started to explain entropy to him. He had no idea what I was talking about, but I was just, the more I talked about it, the more excited I got, and I never heard back from him again. 15, engineering is super versatile. Like, not only are there different fields of engineering, like civil, mechanical, electrical, chemical, but within each one of those fields, there are so many different domains. Like, mechanical, I can't even begin to explain mechanical. Like, there's robotics, like, I do combustion. Like, it's just so broad. There's definitely something everyone can find that they like. 16, certain parts of engineering don't actually require that much heavy math. Like, what I do turbulent flows, and that's like a lot of the Navier-Stokes equations, if you know what any of that is. And that's a lot of math, but there are a lot of parts of engineering that actually don't require that much math. At the beginning, everyone has to learn calculus and ordinary differential equations, but later on, I would say that you can definitely find some engineering fields that don't rely that much on math. Number 17, math and physics actually get to be applied to real life problems. Isn't that great? Like, you thought you wouldn't need any of that math or physics in high school, and I'm here to tell you that you're gonna need it. 18, it gives you opportunities to travel. I'm in Switzerland because, I mean, I guess you can argue that with any job. If you work for a big international company, there's also opportunities to travel with those. 19, you get to meet inspiring people in your work and school. In engineering, generally, I find that it's a very international crowd. Like, you have people that come from all over the world that came to study at McGill in Canada, and now I'm at ETH Zurich in Switzerland, and like, everyone in this program is international. Number 20, you don't just do work that you really like, but you also do really meaningful work. I just find that, like, with engineering solutions, you're actually doing them for like a real world purpose. And I really like that. 21 is engineering is a huge supportive group of people. Like I said, it's not competitive. You're all suffering together. It's pretty great to have friends. I just find that engineering is a really supportive community. Like, even now, I'm meeting other YouTubers, and I find that, like, if I was in any other niche, or niche, whatever, I'm convinced that other YouTubers wouldn't want to help me out. I have this feeling that because I'm in the engineering niche, that is why other YouTubers are helping me out, because they have that engineering mindset. Okay! Alright, okay, I think that's enough for you to mull over. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any reasons why you love engineering, then please leave them in the comments below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more, then please subscribe. I know I'm being really weird right now, but it's because my camera's about to die, and so I'm like just trying to talk as fast as I can. Yes, that's it. Thank you so much for watching. I love you guys so much. I'm really sorry I'm being weird.